Hello everyone and welcome to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. We're glad you're tuned in. We want to give a shout out to our friends at Southern Oregon PBS, KTVL, KDRV, and the Dove Network. Thank you for hosting us on your station. In the Medford School District, we have one shared vision, and that we believe that all are learning, and learning is for all. And what better place to do that than right here on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
I'm Katie Custforth, and I teach kindergarten at Jacksonville Elementary. I'm so excited to be back with you. Now, the last time we were together, I told you about some really special letters called vowels. I sure love letters. They are everywhere. This card right here, it tells you that you can distinguish long from short vowel sounds in spoken syllable, single syllable words. That's a lot of words for you to understand. But what I really want you to remember is long vowels and short vowels. And I'll give you an example of both. I have some cards right here that have long vowel sounds. And the long vowel is when the vowel says its name. Like the letter U in the word cube. That's a fun word to say. Cube. And this one is for the letter I, like bike. You can hear I say its name in bike. This one, this is for a bone. If you have a dog, I bet your dog would like to have a bone. You can hear the letter O say its name in the word bone. I have one more to show you. Cake. Doesn't that look good? You can hear the A say its name in cake. Now, cake sounds delicious, but there's something else at my table that is also delicious. You'll see an apple and a banana. Now, you might know this song already, and if you do, you can sing along with me. And if you don't, you get to learn something new, and I'm excited that I would get to share that with you. I better get my throat ready to do some singing. I like to eat apples and bananas. 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 I like to oat apples and bananas. I like to oat apples and bananas. I like to oot apples and bananas. I like to oot apples and bananas. Now, what's also really fun, if you're feeling a little goofy and silly, you can think of other foods in your house like, I like to eat pizza and tomatoes. I like to eat marshmallows and green beans. I like to eat salad and cereal. I like to eat apples and bananas. Now, hopefully, when you're eating, you use a plate. Now, I'm going to show you a game that you can make with a paper plate. I'm going to move my cards aside. I'm going to move my apple and my banana aside because I want to have just enough room to show you. So here's the things that you'll need. Some cards, if you have them. Some clippies or a safety pin or a bobby pin. That's what I use in my hair. And I have a pen and I have a Sharpie. So if you're going to use a Sharpie, make sure you have a grown-up help you. And then I just have a regular paper plate. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Sharpie and I'm going to draw a line across the middle of my paper plate. And if you want, you can get a grown-up to help you with this. I'm going to try my hardest. Oh, okay. Then I'm going to do another one just like that. Pretty soon your paper plate's going to look like a pie. Oh, look at that. I'm going to do it again. That apples and bananas song is going through my head. Huh, look, I have room for one more. Now it kind of looks like a snowflake. Oh, here's the best part, my listeners. This part right here, this middle, that's what you're going to use for your spinner. So I'm thinking about those vowels again in my head. I know that there was an A and an E and an I and an O and a U. And that's exactly what I'm going to write on my plate. So I'll write an A and an E and an I and an O. I like the letter O because you can't write it backward. Then I'm going to write a U. Oh my gosh, I have some room left. I'm going to keep going. A, E, I. Okay, friends, here's where it gets super fun. I'm going to put my Sharpie away because I don't want it to dry up. I put the lid on it and put it away so it will dry up. You get to decide what you use for your spinner. You can use a clippy like this. I like to use a safety pin because the closed part is kind of heavy and it makes it a spinner that goes around and around and around. And then my ballpoint pen, I'm going to put in the middle. So I like to put the pen in this closed part right here and then save the heavy part for the spinner part. But you can use it how you want to because this is going to be your game. I'm going to get my cards. Now, here's the fun part. I'm going to put my pen in the middle. I'm going to give my spinner a spin. Let's see where it's at. It stopped on the letter U. I'm going to write the letter U on my card and set it aside for later. Then I'm going to spin again. I sure hope I get that letter O. That letter O is fun for me to write. I'm going to go the other way this time. I think I'll try a different hand. Hey, I got the letter A. There's an A in my Katie name. I'm going to practice writing my letters. I'm going to do one more, and then I want to show you how to make a different game. Okay, let's hope I get a O. Ah, I got another A. That's funny. Now I'm going to have two that are the same. I'll practice writing my A. And that was sure fun playing vowels with you. Now I'm going to show you a different game. That was super fun making a game with you with our vowels. So now I want you to make a different game with me. So you'll need a paper plate and your Sharpie, maybe some other markers if you have it, and you'll need a cup. I have things inside my cup, and I'll show you what they are in a minute. The card beside me says, I can read common, grade appropriate, high frequency words by sight. Teachers, we call those sight words, and you can call them that if you want to. Sight words are super hard because sometimes you can't sound them out, and other times you can, and it's a little bit crazy, but I want to show you a fun way that you can learn your sight words. Maybe by now you've been talking with your teacher, maybe on a Chromebook, maybe on your phone, or maybe you see your teacher from far, far away and you can say, hi, tell me what word to practice. So make sure you check with your teacher what sight words you should be working on. So I'm going to take my Sharpie one more time. I'm going to draw a line down the middle of my plate like I did last time. Kind of makes a funny sound. And then I'm going to go across because I really want that middle part. Now, I think I'm going to leave this just like that. I'm going to put the word I. And I know that I is always capital. So I'm going to write the word I. That's another word that you cannot write backward. That is really fun. I'm going to write the word my, because my, oh my, am I having fun with you. M-Y is the word that spells my. M-Y is the word that spells my. M-Y spells my. M-Y spells my. M-Y is the word that spells my. I think I'm going to use the word she. She is a fun word. S-H-E, S-H-E, S-H-E spells she. S-H-E, S-H-E, S-H-E spells she. Oh my gosh, I just discovered something. If I cover up the letter S in the word she, there's a word hiding in there. The word he is hiding in the word she. In my next space, I'm going to write the word he. H-E is the word that spells he. H-E is the word that spells he. H-E spells he. H-E spells he. H-E is the word that spells he. So in my cup that's right by me, remember my pool noodle that I wrote letters on and I cut apart? I have the pieces of my pool noodle. Oh, I have the letter E. Two of the words on my plate have the letter E. Let's see what the next letter is. I have an H. That's the word I just wrote. H-E. So there's a couple things you can do. You can spin your spinner. If you still have your safety pin, you can use that. There's other things you can try too. So I'll put my safety pin in the middle. I want to be really careful. Then you can spin your spinner. Oh, I landed on the word she. Now I know the word she has the letter H. So what I can do is I can stack the letter H right there because I know it's in there. Now, maybe I'll get the letter she again. I better get it out of the way. Oh, I did get the letter she. There's the E that's in the word she. There's a couple things you can do, my friends. You can match the letters to the words on here. Here's something else you can do because I like to practice writing my sight words because they're so hard for me. I'm going to spin that spinner. Oh, yeah, I got the word he this time. So I'll take my card. My favorite color is blue, so I'm going to use this color blue to write the word he. H and then an E. I'm going to spin one more time. See if I get the word that's the same or not the same. Oh, I got the word my. He, my. That's a fun word to say. My, oh my. My. My game is fun. I hope you have fun making a game out of a paper plate, some cards, make a spinner, match your letters. Hope you have fun doing that. That was sure fun making a game with you with a paper plate. So now what I want you to think about is measuring things. I know we made a game with letters, but now I want to talk to you a little bit about numbers. Numbers are just as fun as letters. You'll see on my card here that it says I can measure two objects to compare height and length. Height is how tall something is, and length is how long something is. Now, you might have seen one of these in your classroom. It's called a ruler, and of course, it's my favorite color. You can use a ruler to measure how tall something is, or how long something is, or if you go in your garage, you might have one of these. This is a tape measure. I like to call it a measure tape. Now, inside of this is kind of like a ruler like this one. So I'll open it up so that you can see it. And while I'm opening it, I want you to say, I promise to be careful with other people's tools. I hope you said that with me. So these are two different tools you can use to measure things, how high they are or how long they are, how tall they are, how long they are. But I found some other things in my garage when I was looking for this measuring tape. I found the itty bittiest little screwdriver. Look how little it is. But then I found something that was quite a bit bigger. You can measure anything you want. You can measure different shoes. You can find some toys in your house, maybe a big stuffed animal and a little stuffed animal. Maybe a big car and a little car. Maybe a big dump truck and a little dump truck. You can measure anything you want. Now, moms and dads at home, this is a great time to get some toys maybe you've had packed away for a while. You can bring them back out again. What a great memory you can create with your kids. So first thing I'm going to do is take my ruler. I don't think I want to measure with my ruler. I'm going to put that away. I'm going to take my tape measure, and I'm going to put that away too because I found some other things that you can measure with that I want to show you. I found some ribbon that says Merry Christmas. It's not Christmas. And I found a piece of rope. I found a shoelace. There's so many things you can do with these, but I'm going to use them to measure. So I think I'll put my rope aside because I have a lot of rope. I could save that for another day, but I'm really excited about Merry Christmas ribbon. On my paper that's on the table here, you can see I have this tool and that tool. I just think that squatty screwdriver is the cutest thing ever. I'm going to start by tracing. I'm going to trace these. So in case I lose my place, I'll remember this is the tool that I was measuring. I'm going to leave it on the table just like that. Then I'll trace this squatty screwdriver. That's kind of a funny word, that word squatty. Here it is. Okay, I'm going to try and leave them there. I think I will measure the biggest one first, the longest one. I'm going to take my Merry Christmas ribbon. I'm going to stretch it from here to here. I'm going to leave it right there, and then I'm going to cut it with my scissors. If you don't have scissors, then you can maybe have a grown-up help you figure out another way that you could cut that. Okay, so there's my Merry Christmas ribbon. Then I'm going to use my shoelace. I have a lot of shoelace. One part of my shoelace is broken. There's no way I could have used this in a pair of shoes. Make sure you ask somebody before you get a shoelace. If you take a shoelace out of your shoes, then your shoes won't work the right way. So really check with your family first. Okay, my friends, I have a piece of Christmas ribbon and I have a piece of shoelace. But when we traced our tools, now look what happens. I have a picture of it right there and a picture of it right there. Even when I take my tools away, or if you measure toys or shoes, you can trace them with a pencil or a marker. But look at this. The ribbon will fit totally inside of there. Ta-da! And the shoelace will fit totally inside of my squatty screwdriver. Ba-ba-da! That was so fun measuring with you. I hope you find some things at home that you can measure. Now remember to ask before you take tools, but still have fun measuring two objects so you compare their length and their height. Have fun. I have a new card for you that I want to show you. And it says, I can represent addition and subtraction with objects, fingers, and drawings. So I'm going to show you a couple ways you can do that. Now that word addition, that's a big word. It's hiding the word add. An add is when we put things together. And if you've been watching Ninja Math with my teacher friend Kristen, then you'll remember that adding is when we put things together. And subtraction, that's when you take things away. And it sounds kind of mean, take away. But with numbers, it's super fun. So for this one, you're going to want a paper plate. And we had mac and cheese at our house, but I saved the cup. So if you have something like this, you could use that. Or you can use a regular cup, maybe your favorite cup. Or if you have a lunch bag, remember the lunch bag that we made books out of? You could use one of those also. Now I was looking around in my kitchen for something that I could use to make a game with you. I found it. I found some noodles in this bag. There's two different kind of noodles. I'm gonna mix them up, but I wanna show them to you first. There's bow ties. I like these just cause they're cute. Look, you could kind of make a bow out of it. And I like this kind too. These are called spiral noodles or curly noodles. These remind me of my hair. So I'm gonna take the noodles in that bag. I'm gonna mix and a mix and a mix, mix, mix. And I'm gonna take some out. I love the word some because we never know how many it is till we count them. So I have some in my hand. I'm going to put it in my cup, and I'm going to show you what I want you to do with your plate. Almost the same as last time. It's a different plate this time. I'm going to draw a line across the middle. Now my plate is cut in half. So on half of your plate, you're going to draw another line like this. And here's where the fun begins. You're going to take the noodles that you just put in your cup, take them all out this time, not just some, but all of them, and then bring, sprinkle them in your plate. Then you're going to separate them, which means you're going to take them apart. I'll put my curly noodles on one side, and then I'll put my bow tie noodles on the other side. That's a lot of bows. Look at that. Now, it looks to me like I definitely have more bow ties than I do my curly noodles, but the only way to know for sure is to count them. So I'm going to count my bows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 bow ties. Then I'm going to count my curly noodles. 1, 2. Oh, it rolled away. Come back. 1, 2, 3, 4. Whoa, I definitely have more bow ties than I do curlies. But now what I want to do, I want to do some addition with you, which is when you put the things together. So I'm going to count the noodles together. If you want to count them with me, you can, or you can just listen. I'm going to start with the bow ties because those are my favorite. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have 10 noodles on my plate. Well, now that I know how many I had on there, then I can make it onto a card, and it's called an equation. Now, it says on my card over here, I can use objects like my noodles, fingers, or drawings. So I'm going to do some of that. I'm going to take one of my cards. I'm going to try my best to draw my noodles. So I hope you're ready to draw with me. I know I had 6 bow ties, so I'm going to write the number 6 so I don't forget. And I know I had 4 curly noodles, so I'm going to write the number 4 so I don't forget. And I know we're adding them together, and so I'm going to put the plus sign because we're putting things together. And that looks kind of like the letter T. So let's find out. Here's my bows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I need one more. 6. This will be fun to make 4 curlies. 1, 2, 3, 4. And because we just counted them on our plate, we know that 6 bow ties plus 4 curly noodles, that was 10 noodles altogether. And we want to know what it is. So we'll put it right here. We'll put equal. And I like the number 10 because it's a 1 stuck to a 0. What's fun about this card is now you can color the bow ties if you want. You could even color them the same color as this rainbow. You could color the curlies if you want. Maybe you want purple curly hair. You could color purple curly hair. Now that was so much fun for me. I want to do one more and see if we get the same or if we get something a little bit different. But I think I want to try subtraction. So what I need to do is take all of my noodles away and put them back in my cup. I'm gonna take some more out of my bag, but I wanna save some for later too, so I'll put some more in. I like that mixing sound. Okay, now I need to mix and a mix and a mix, 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 and dump all of it. Whoa, I don't think it'll fit in my hand, so I think I'll pour it out this time. That's fun to pour things. Oh my gosh, look at this pile of noodles. Okay, I think I'll put my bows on the other side this time. And I'll put my curlies over here. And while I'm moving these, you could use anything. You could use buttons. You could use paper clips. You can use shoes. You can use ponytail holders. You can use anything. I just wanted to use noodles. Okay. It looks to me like I still have more bow ties, but just to be certain, I want to count them. If you want to count with me, you can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 bow ties. Now let's count the curlies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can totally do subtraction with this because one of the numbers is bigger than the other one. And when you do subtraction, you have to have a bigger number first. So I'm going to start with those bow ties. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I wanted to double check. So I'm going to write a 9. Now here's where it gets a little bit tricky when you do subtraction, when you take things away. We know that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 curlies. Well, I'm not going to draw curlies, but I am going to take 6 bows away. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. 6 got taken away, and I know I have some left, but I'm going to write some numbers on my card first so I don't forget what my number was. Now, takeaway is just a little line that looks like this. So 9, takeaway, we took 6 noodles away, and then here's our equal, and we know we have some left. Let's see how many we have left. Count with me this time. 1, 2, 3. There's only 3 little bow ties left. So then I'll write the number 3 right here. Now, this is where subtraction or take away, it feels kind of mean sometimes when you say take away, but it doesn't have to be. It can be really fun. So here's our 9 bow ties. 1, 2. They look a little different than my last bow ties, but that's okay. I'm just having fun drawing with you. Here's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm almost there. 8. 1 more is 9. Now, if you want to double check, you can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, then we're going to take 6 of them and cross them off like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And there's our ones that are left over. We knew we had some left over, but we didn't know how many till we counted them. 9. Take away 6 equals 3. And there it is. 1, 2, 3. So if you have a paper plate at home, and if you have things that are different, like noodles or M&Ms and raisins or peanuts and almonds or blah, 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 and some blah, blah, blah. Whatever it is that you have fun with. And I hope you have fun representing addition and subtraction with objects, fingers, and drawings. Have fun. Thank you for watching Medford Anywhere Learning TV. I'll see you the next time.
Thanks for tuning in to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. Medford School District is a place where all are learning, and learning is for all.